Hi, in this video, we'll see about a sensor which can be interfaced to Raspberry Pi over I2C pins or over I2C protocol. Let's begin. So this sensor is called as BMP180, which was also previously available as BMP085. The beautiful thing about this sensor is it's an integrated, very small form factor sensor, as you can see here. And it has got an I2C interface. Now, with I2C interface, the benefit is you all need only two pins to interface it with Raspberry Pi. Those two pins are called as SDA and SCL. More about how I2C works and what are the details about I2C are given along with this video, which you can read in your spare time. To interface this with Raspberry Pi and to write down a program for it, however, it is not required that you have to have a complete understanding of I2C. You can just know the basic fundamentals and you can start writing your program by interfacing this sensor with Raspberry Pi. So let's see what this sensor gives. This is a Bosch manufactured sensor which gives integrated temperature, pressure and altitude values. It works on 3.3 volt power supply, but the sensor module as such, which looks like this over here, we don't use that, but we usually purchase a big PCB which is having the sensor on it. So you need not worry about the power supply. Even if you apply 3.3 volt or even if you apply 5 volt here, it will be converted to 3.3 volt for the sensor using the on-chip regulator. As said, it works on I2C protocol. And one another benefit of I2C protocol is at a time you can also connect multiple devices on I2C. I'll just give you a very short idea about it, not technically, but how physically I2C will work. So if this is the Raspberry Pi that you have, then I2C has got two pins as said. One is called as SDA and another one is called as SCL. Now with these two pins, what happens? You can connect one, two or multiple such sensors directly. Let me show you how we can connect two of them. So these devices will have the same pins called SDA and SCL for interfacing, and every device has a specific I2C address associated with it. With that address, that device is identified and we can interface many devices at a time. Since the address in I2C is a 7-bit address, therefore a maximum of 128 devices can be connected in I2C bus, because 7-bit addressing can generate address from 0 to 127. So this is how we can interface it with Raspberry Pi. At a time, if you want, you can also interface two different, the same BMP 080, 085 or BMP 180 sensors. But in that case, you will have to change its address. Now let's see how exactly we can use this sensor. So if you buy a module of this sensor, most probably you will get something like this or like this shown here. So it's a complete sensor module which has also got on-chip voltage regulator. Now if you look at the I2C pinout, or if you have to look at the Raspberry Pi pinout or the total GPIO structure, then you can identify the I2C pins like this. So this one over here, it's SDA, and the pin below it is SCL, which are GPIO2 and GPIO3. I2C sensor should not be connected to any other GPIO. It should must be, and it should be always only connected to I2C pins. Raspberry Pi has got an I2C on the processor itself, and therefore just take a note of these pins and let's see how we can interface this sensor. So this is how the interfacing will go. As such, it is very simple. If you look at even here, you can get to know about it. So you have to connect this VCC to 3.3 volt, connect ground to ground, connect the SCL pin to SCL, and connect SDA pin to SDA. So that's it, and the sensor is interfaced to Raspberry Pi. But it doesn't end here. Because once you interface the sensor to Raspberry Pi, we have to enable the I2C of Raspberry Pi. By default, when you install operating system on it, the I2C is not enabled. So the first thing to do is we have to enable the I2C protocol. Let's see how we can enable the I2C protocol on Raspberry Pi and see if we can connect the sensor properly to it or not. So these are the steps to enable the I2C in Raspberry Pi. We will have to open up the Raspberry Pi config menu using a command called sudo raspi-config. Then such a window will come up where if you look into the seventh option, that is this, or sorry, not seventh, the fifth option, that is interfacing options. So if you have to, or if you go to the interfacing options, then you will see another interfacing option like this, where you can enable the interface for camera, SSH, VNC, SPI, I2C, serial, one wire, and remote GPIO. You must have done or you must have gone through it to enable the SSH and VNC before. Now, go to the I2C and then simply enable it. Once you enable the I2C interface in the Raspberry Pi GPIO, and once you connect the sensor to the Raspberry Pi, you can then check if the sensor is connected properly or not using a very simple command. Remember, after enabling the I2C, always remember, after enabling the I2C, restart is important, okay? You have to restart the Raspberry Pi after enabling I2C. And then you can use this command, sudo I2C detect hyphen space hyphen y space 1. After this command, a list of devices connected to I2C will come up, which will show the address of the BMP180 sensor that you have connected to Raspberry Pi, if it is properly connected. If not, the address will not be shown. So that's a very simple debugging to know whether the sensor is properly connected or not. Let's do all these steps practically in the next video. Thank you. Now, as you can see, this is the BMP180 sensor that I have. It's quite small in the form factor. That's how it looks. On the bottom side of the sensor, you will see the pin names are mentioned: VIN, ground, SCL, SDA. Depending upon which module you have, the order of the pins may change. It may not be the same. However, you have to make sure that you connect it properly. So let's make the connections. First of all, I will connect a VIN pin. So this pin should go to as specified VCC. You can connect it to 5V or 3.3V, completely up to you. Then connect the ground pin that I am connecting next, as shown in the diagram. So, ground. Make sure to connect all the connectors first. Here I am using the female to female connecting wires. Now the VCC is connected. Now the ground is to be connected in this pin here. That's okay. Then the next pin here on the sensor, it's called as SCL after the VCC and ground. Okay. So SCL, as shown by the green figure here, should go to the third pin from the left hand side, or pin number 5. So this is SCL, and then SDA or data. Now my sensor is connected to Raspberry Pi. Now let us open VNC viewer and try to enable the I2C interface over here. So this is the Raspberry Pi login. Just simply open, I'll just keep this camera window aside. Open the command prompt and then go to sudo raspi-config. This opens the configuration window for us. As said, go to interfacing options and then I2C. In interfacing options, just go to I2C and hit enter. It will ask, would you like the ARM I2C interface to be enabled? Using your left arrow key, simply shift to yes and hit enter. That will enable the ARM I2C interface. Now just go to finish and as said, do a reboot. Once you perform the reboot, we can use the command prompt to check if the sensor is properly connected or not. The reboot usually takes around 10 to 15 seconds. So let's just wait here. As we can see, the system has rebooted. So let's open the command prompt and let's check if the sensor is connected properly or not. So open the terminal and the command to check is sudo i2c detect space dash or hyphen y space 1. Sudo i2c detect hyphen y space 1 and simply hit enter. Now can you see something at the address called 77 is appearing over here? It simply means that our device has been properly connected to the bus. If, for example, if I remove one of the wires, let's say I'll remove this SDA pin or the last SDA pin over here, and I have removed one wire here. Now let's try to run this command again. We'll see that now what happens. Now you can see nothing is shown over here at address 77, or in fact the 77 address itself is not shown. So it will show up or it will come up only when you connect the sensor. Now I have connected the sensor. If I rerun the command again, I can see 77 coming up over here. This means you have properly enabled the I2C of Raspberry Pi computer. And you have also properly made the wiring between the sensor and Raspberry Pi, and the sensor is properly and healthily connected to the computer and is now ready to use. In the next video, we'll see how we can write down program for it and see its output. Thank you. Hi. Now that we have seen how we can enable I2C for Raspberry Pi and how to connect the sensor, let's try to see how we can write down a program for it. Now, before writing a program for it on Raspberry Pi, it is important that we install the I2C related library for Python in Raspberry Pi. This is the command to install the library in Raspberry Pi. Sudo apt get install python smbus. Once we install this library, then we'll be able to see how we can write down program for this sensor. So let's begin. So let me close the presentation now, which we don't want anymore. And now let us log into our Raspberry Pi. VNC viewer, the IP address of Raspberry Pi, and here we are. So, as said, first thing first is installing the library. The command for the library is sudo apt get install python-smbus. Most probably, the library would be already present in your Raspberry Pi. If it is not, then this command will help install the library for you. Just hit enter and see what happens. The command says Python SMBus library is already the newest version. So we don't need to worry about it. The library is already latest. Now let's look into the code for it. Now what I have done is I have written the code for this particular sensor in two files. One acts as a package or library file, and another one will be our main program from which we will call this package. The package is called as bmpsensor.py, and all you have to do is you have to keep this package in the folder where you want to keep your main program. So wherever you are creating this program, it doesn't matter. If it is on desktop, then desktop. If it is on any other folder, then keep it in any other folder. The only thing is this file should be present in the folder where you are going to write down this code. Let's look at the code. Now, as you can see, this is the testing code for our BMP pressure and temperature sensor module that we have created. The program is very simple. So what you have to do first is import BMP sensor. That's the reason I told you to keep the BMP sensor.py library in the same folder where you have kept the main program or your testing program. So it can anyways be testbmp.py or testmysensor.py or mymainprogram.py. It can be anything. It doesn't matter. The only thing is this BMP sensor.py file should be present in the same folder. So import BMP sensor, then import time to generate or induce some delays. And this is how we can read it. Remember, the order of these three values is important because this module or this library that we have is returning the sensor values in the prescribed order only. So first it returns temp, the second value returned is pressure, and the third value returned is altitude. Temperature is in degree Celsius, pressure is in PA or Pascals, and altitude is in meters. Now let's run the program and see if the values are correct or not. So this is giving us degree Celsius, this is giving us pressure in Pascals. You may want to convert it to kilopascals by applying some formula. For now, let's keep it in Pascal, and this is going to give us the altitude in meters. Let's run the code. As we can see, the temperature is 30, pressure is 94,600 something, and altitude is 574. So this is for my own geographical location. Temperature is of course my room temperature. So if I start an air conditioning unit now, the temperature will start to reduce drastically. And if I just do something with this sensor, or let me just rub my hand a little bit, and if I just touch it over here, then the temperature reading should be immediately increased. You can see 33, 34, something like that. Make sure you only touch this metallic part and don't touch the electronic circuit part or the tiny components over there. So you can just rub your finger to a surface. It becomes quite hot momentarily. Now see, the temperature sensed is 35.1. The pressure and altitude values are not going to change no matter what you do. Another way to increase the temperature is simply press that module a little bit like that, and you will see the rise in temperature. So now it's 35.1 degrees Celsius. So this is how you can write a Python program and then incorporate it in any of your project programs or any of your project. BMP 180 is a very easy and simple to use sensor which can be incorporated with Raspberry Pi. Thank you for watching.